next, was achieved in the time of next? And could it be done again?
Okay, so first part of the question, I think what next did was basically start a renaissance in journalism in this country. The rest of the industry, when they sort of been a little bit less defensive, admit quietly, and I speak to editors regularly, that we forced them to up their game. Because I think before we came along, people had sort of forgotten that journalism is at its core about accountability and holding public office holders, you know, responsible, and all of that. But beyond that, there was also a certain staleness that I think had settled into the Nigerian media space, even in the way the arts was covered, in the way they did fashion, in the way they did the really significant things, I think, that journalism is supposed to do. And I think what next did was essentially a wake-up call to say that, no, you can't do that, you know, you've got to do this properly. And even though we ended up not making it, I think the impact we had on the sector was very, very significant. You know, I think we changed things, we forced industries to redo everything. And even today, if you look around, people from Next, including those who sort of started out of Next, are still occupying very significant position in the national consciousness. You are an example, I think. And a whole bunch of people like Victor Oyikamemo, people like Mr. Tony Khan. There's a whole plethora of amazing human beings, I think, that came out of the Next stable. And continue to be really important for the national work. So, yes, I'm very proud of that association. Could it be done again? Not in the way we did it, because I think we are approaching the era of the end of print. I think news is now mobile, is fast, is changing. But if what you're talking about is the essence of what Next was trying to do, and then yes, it can be done, it should be done. But if you're talking about sort of the form in which it took, then I'm saying no, possibly not.
Is there a sense that, do you get a sense that with the failure of Next, the status quo reasserted itself?
In some ways.
And is that depressing?
It is depressing. It is depressing. But on the other hand, we now have the growth of social media. So the ability to control news in the way that traditionally Nigerian papers allowed themselves to be controlled has died. You know, it used to be you could. What many people didn't understand about the Nigerian media space at that time was it wasn't so much what was published that was significant, it was actually what was kept out. So there was a practice in which important things would happen, things that the public had a right to know, but people would get together and decide we're not going to publish. And I think that was the most damaging thing about that particular era. And so the fact that you can't do that now because of social media and the fact that people are publishing is important. And if I may add, is one of the reasons why we will fight the social media bill, because any attempt to actually model social media is an attempt to take us back. Because what social media has done is to democratize information and make it impossible to sort of, if you like, shape and hide and all of that. And so, you know, I'm very proud of the fact that we came together as an industry, finally, and we issued a very strong reordering statement in which we sort of made it clear to the government, and this is, I'm talking about Newspaper Proprietors Association, online publishers, a whole group of people in the media industry, that we will fight that bill, because we think actually the essence of it will not be about fake news or hate speech, it will be really to muzzle citizens and also muzzle
us. you heard it at this stage, we're going to fight the social media bill. I'm trying to get a sense for how much time we have left. 15 minutes, okay.